Dominus ad extris tuis, confridit in dire sua regi. Gloria in Patri et Filio, in Spiritu
I technical efforts. Out of 28 postulants, 16 or 17 are ready to enter the novitiate. Let's consider the doubtful ones again. There's Irmgard.
Reverend Mother, there's no doubt about Irmgard. The religious life is no place for the pious.
You mean the pretentious pious, Sister Bertha. There's Christina. And then, there's Maria.
Well, after last night, I don't think there can be any doubt in Reverend Mother's mind about Maria.
Well, I gave her permission to leave the Abbey for the day.
I told you, Sister Bertha.
Ave.
Reverend Mother, I've brought Maria. She's waiting.
Sister Sophia, the mistress of the novices and the mistress of the postulants do not see eye to eye about Maria. How do you feel about her?
Oh, I love her very dearly. But she always seems to be in trouble, doesn't she?
Exactly what I say. She climbs a tree and scrapes my knee. My dress has got a tear. She waltzes on her way to mass and whistles on the stair. And underneath her wimple, she has colors in her hair. She's always late for everything, except for every meal. I hate to have to say it, but I very firmly feel Maria's not a master to the Abbey.
I'd like to say a word in her behalf.
Oh, let's say it, Sister Margareta.
Maria makes me laugh.
Margareta heard me open the gate.
Very few of us were asleep, We could only think that you've lost your way, and to be lost at night on that mountain.
Oh, Rishima, I couldn't be lost on that mountain. Oh, that's my mountain. I was brought up on it. It was the mountain that led me to you.
Oh?
You see, when I was a little girl, I used to come down the mountain. I'd climb a tree and I'd look over into your gardens. Oh, many times I went back up that mountain in the dark. Oh, singing all the way. Which brings up another transgression. I was singing yesterday and I was singing without your permission.
Don't worry, I tell me you're in the abbey that there's a rule about singing.
That's the hardest rule of all for me. Sister Marguerite has always reminded me, but too late after I started singing.
That day you were singing in the garden at the top of your voice.
Well, it's that kind of song.
I came to the window. You saw me and you stopped.
Oh, yes. That's been on my mind ever since it happened.
It's been on my mind, too. I used to sing that song when I was a child, and I couldn't quite remember. Please?
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Creamed colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters and melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when the fields sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Green-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things. And then I don't feel so bad.
When the dog bites,
when the bee stings,
when I'm feeling sad,
I simply
God and to do it heartfully.
Even if it is hard to accept.
Even then.
Maria, the dress you wore when you came to us, is that still in the robing room?
Oh, I know, Mother. I'm sure that's been given to the poor. Sister Margaret always says that when we enter the abbey, our... Oh, Reverend Mother, why do you ask?
Maria, it seems to be the will of God that you leave us.
Oh, leave. Leave here. Oh, no, Mother.
For a while only, Maria.
Oh, please don't send me away, Mother. This is my life. This is what I want.
Maria, but perhaps if you go out into the world again for a time, you'll return to us knowing what we expect of you and that we do expect it.
I know what you expect, Mother, and I'll do it. I pro...
Maria?
Well, if it's God's will, then where am I to go?
There's a family of 7 children.
7 children?
You like children.
But 7?
You're good with them. They need a governess until September.
Oh, until September, Reverend Mother.
Captain Fulltrop expects you this afternoon. He's a fine man, and a brave one. He was given the Maria Theresa Medal by the Emperor. It was for heroism in the Adriatic.
Oh, a captain of the Navy. He'll be very strict, Reverend Mother.
You're not being sent to his battleship, child. Bless you, Maria.
Certain everything will turn out
Yes, sir?
I was calling the housekeeper and she didn't answer. Do you know why?
Oh, sometimes she doesn't hear, sir.
I'm sorry, sir. I was answering the telephone. Good day, sir. Happy to have you home with you.
Why did the last governess leave?
Who knows? She just said, I've had enough of this, and walked out.
Why? Was Louisa playing tricks on her again? Putting toads in her bed?
She didn't complain of that, sir.
Well, there's a new one coming today, and this one can't walk out.
Oh?
She's from Longbrook Abbey, with orders to stay until September.
I hope you'll be at home for a time, sir.
Just until tomorrow. That telephone call, was it for me?
No, sir, it was for France. While you were gone, a call came from Vienna. A Frau Schreider. I have the number in the pension.
I know the number. Oh, I should be back in about a month with some guests.
Yes, sir. You know how many, sir?
Just two. Herr Detweiler.
Ah, Herr Detweiler.
And Frau Schreider.
Well, who wanted me on the telephone?
It was the post office. They've got a telegram. It will be delivered at 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock? And yeah, it's me about 5 hours to be nervous.
But that's scatterbrained word that means telegrams.
Well, that's one thing people are saying. If the Germans did take over Austria, we'd have a fishing sale.
Don't let the captain hear you say that. He never whistled for us when his wife was alive.
Speaking of the captain of a ship again.
I can't bear being whistled for. It's humiliating.
In the Imperial Navy, the bosun always whistled for us.
But I wasn't in the Imperial Navy.
That's too bad. You could have made a fortune. You will wait here.
Captain von Trapp, and you are Fräulein?
Maria Ryan.
Ah, Fräulein. Would you mind stepping over there for a second? Before you meet with the children, you will put on another dress.
Oh, but sir, I haven't any other dress. When we enter the abbey, our worldly clothes are given to the poor.
And what about this one?
Well, the portion brought this one.
It belonged to our last postulant. Well, I would have made myself a dress, but I wasn't given time. I can make my own clothes.
Good. I see that you're given some material today, if possible. Now, you will be in charge of the children. There are 7 of them. You will see how far they've progressed with their studies and carry on from there. Each morning will be spent in the classroom, and each afternoon they march. You will see that at all times they conduct themselves with decorum and orderliness. The first rule in this household is discipline.
Oh, yes, sir.
This is your new governess, Fräulein Maria. As I sound your signal, you will step forward and repeat your name. You, Fräulein, will listen and learn their signals so that you can call them when you want them.
Lisa.
Frederick.
Louisa.
Kurt.
Brigitte.
Martha.
Gretel.
Now, for what? Let's see how much you whistle.
Oh, but Captain, I won't have to whistle them. What I mean is I'll be with them all the time, sir.
Not on all occasions. This is a large house in a large estate. They've been told only to come when they hear the signal. They want to want you, this is what you'll hear.
Oh, sir, you won't have to trouble. Oh, because I couldn't answer to a whistle. It would be too humiliating.
That's nonsense. Everyone in this household answers to a whistle. I'll show you.
Yes, sir?
This is my orderly. The butler. The new governess, Fräulein Maria.
Yes, sir?
This is the executive officer, Frau Schmidt, the housekeeper. The new governess, Fräulein Maria. Please make sure that your room is ready.
Yes, sir.
I shall now leave you with the children. You are in command.
Oh, pardon me, sir. I didn't know how to address you.
You shall call me Captain.
Thank you, Captain. Oh, I forgot to return a whistle, Captain. I won't be needing it, Captain. Well, children, now that this is us, would you please be so kind as to tell me your names again and tell me how old you are? Now you are?
I'm Lisa. I'm 16 years old, and I don't need a governess.
Well, I'm glad you told me, Lisa. We'll just be good friends.
I'm Frederick. I'm 14. I'm a boy.
A boy? Oh, why, you're almost a man.
I'm Brigitte.
You didn't tell me how old you are, Louisa.
I'm Brigitte, and she's Louisa. And she's 13 years old. And you're smart. I'm 9, and I think your dress is the ugliest one I've ever seen.
No, Brigitte, you mustn't say something like that.
Why not? Don't you think it's ugly?
If I didn't think so, I wouldn't say so. I'm Kurt. And I'm 11. Almost.
Oh, that's a nice age to be a kid. 11 almost.
I'm Martha, and I'm going to be 7 on Tuesday. And I like a pink parasol.
Oh, you know, pink is my favorite color, too. Oh, and you must be Gretel. Well, I must tell you something. I've never been a governess before. Now, where do I start?
You mean you don't know anything about being a governess?
Well, no, I don't.
Well, the first thing you have to do is to tell Father to mind his own business.
No, Louisa, don't. Shh. I like her.
What's in here?
Oh, it's my guitar.
Well, what did you bring this for?
For when we all sing together.
We don't sing.
Of course you sing. Everybody sings. What songs do you know?
We don't know any songs.
You don't?
No.
Well, now I know where to start. I'm going to teach you how to sing. Let's start at the very beginning. A very good place to start. When you read, you begin with
A, B, C.
When you sing, you begin with Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi. The first three notes just happen to be Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti. Oh, come. I'll make it easier for you. Listen.
Oh, a deer, a female deer, ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name, I call myself, far, a long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread, la, a note to follow, so.
Bring us back to
a deer, a female deer,
ray,
a drop of golden sun.
that what you call a song?
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, and so on.
No, children.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, and so on are only the tools we use to build a song. Once we have these notes in our head, we can sing a million different tunes.
How?
Oh, well, by mixing them up together, like this. So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re. Now you do that.
So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re.
So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
And now all together. And
so, do, la.
One word for every note.
Oh yes, Brigitte, I did.
But when you sing anything, you are using up three notes on one word.
Oh yes, that's right. Well, sometimes we do that.
Now all together.
And
when you know the notes to sing, you can sing most anything.
Thank you.
night, Ralph.
Please, Ralph. You don't have to say goodnight this early just because your father's home.
How did you know my father's home?
Well, I have a way of knowing things.
Oh, wonderful.
No, not really.
Oh, yes, you are. I mean, how did you know that exactly at this time tonight you will have a telegram to deliver to France?
Everyone this lady always gets a birthday telegram from your sister.
You see, you are wonderful.
Lizel, can I come again tomorrow night?
Ralph, you can't be sure you're going to have a telegram to deliver you tomorrow night.
I could come here by mistake. It's a telegram from Colonel Schweider. He's here from Berlin. He's staying with the Garlighters. No one's supposed to know he's here. Don't you tell your father that.
Why not?
Well, your father's pretty Austrian.
We're all Austrian.
Some people think we ought to be Germans. They're pretty mad at those that think so. They're getting ready to... Well, that's just how your father's getting into any trouble.
Don't worry about father. He was decorated for bravery.
I know. The only one I worry about is his daughter.
Me? Why?
How old are you, Lisa?
I'm 16. What's wrong with that?
You wait, little girl, on an empty stage, for fate to turn the lights on. Your love, little girl, is an empty grave that men will want to write on. You are 16, going on 17, baby, it's time to think. Thank you.
Oh, I'm getting ready for bed.
The captain is going to Vienna tomorrow. I have this material he ordered for a new dress for you.
Oh, how nice of him. Oh, even before it's late, this is the prettiest dress I've ever had. Oh, well, I hope the captain will like it, because I want to ask for more material.
More?
Oh, not for me, silly. For the children. I want to make them some play clothes.
The Von Trapp children never play. The captain doesn't like them to get dirty.
Oh, but they're children. Oh, they have to climb trees and roll on the grass and think of all the rocks in
the captain says the best exercise is marching. The children will continue to march. I hope you find the new room comfortable.
Oh, yes. Thank you very much.
There will be new curtains for the window and the alcove. They'll be hung tomorrow.
Oh, but these curtains are very good.
There will be new curtains.
Will the captain be away long?
I don't know. Of course, he has to come home every time he goes to the governess. I sometimes think the children would be with their governesses just because they want to see their father.
Oh, but he must want to see them too.
Since his wife died, they remind too much of him. Oh, you can put that away. You won't be using it.
Well, why not?
The captain won't have music here.
Oh, he won't have music here.
And he used to love music. There were wonderful evenings here. His wife would sing and he'd play the violin or guitar. But now he shuts all that out of his life.
So that's why he's the way he is. Oh, but not to have music, that's wrong for him and wrong for the children too.
It will work out. The captain may marry again before the summer.
Oh, that would change everything. But the children have a new mother again.
It's raining. You'd better close your window.
Dear God, I know now that you've sent me on a mission. I must help these children to love the new mother and prepare them to win her love so she will never want them to leave her. And I pray that this will become a happy family in my sight. God bless the captain, God bless Liesel, Friedrich, Martha, Brigitte, Louisa, and little Gretel. And oh yes, I forgot the old boy's name. What's his name? Well, God bless what's his name. God bless the Reverend Mother and everybody at the Nuremberg Abbey. Oh, and now, dear God, about Liesel. Help her to know that I'm afraid, and help her to tell me what she's been up to. Help me to be understanding, so that I may guide her footsteps. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Well, I was out taking a walk in the gardens, and someone closed the doors earlier than usual, and I didn't want to wake anyone, so I thought that maybe... Oh, you meant to tell Father. Oh, Liesel, did you climb these trees to get up here? You should see Louisa climb. She can do it with a toad in her hand.
Toads?
That's how we used to bed sheets in our governesses. Liesel, were you out walking all by yourself? You know, if we wash this dress out tonight, nobody will notice it tomorrow. You could put this on. Now take your dress in there and put yourself in the bathtub. Okay, come back here and sit at the edge of my bed and we'll have a nice little talk. You know, this morning I said that I don't need a governess. Maybe I'll be.
Lady, or let it fall. Thus take you from the goat's throat, lady, or let it fall.
musty clear from the goats and throat, and lady, oh, lady, oh, lady, oh.
Stretch of woods over there. If the wind moves through it, it's like a restless sea.
Oh, and that sweet little village?
That's not a village, that's a town.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
It's fun being here with you. You're quite an experience for me.
Well, you're quite an experience for me, too. Somewhere in you, there's a fascinating man. Occasionally, I catch a glimpse of him. And when I do, he's exciting.
Exciting? Never been called exciting before.
I'm beginning to understand you better now that I see you here. you know? You're a little like those mountains, except that you keep on moving. How can you be away from this place as much as you are?
Maybe I've just been searching for reason to stay.
I like it here very much, Gail.
Max can't still be on the telephone. I know he's searching for singers for the Colesburg Festival, but you like it here.
Oh, we have to spend some time in Vienna. I've got Hayley's estate to look after.
I thought that was a corporation now.
It is, and I'm president.
You, president of a corporation.
After all, I managed Hayley's affairs for years before he died.
I just can't imagine you sitting behind a desk.
Well, of course. I wear a business suit and smoke a big cigar.
Excuse me, Captain. Herr Detweiler would like his coffee now.
Why, his telephone?
Oh, he just finished. How would you like this for the Colesburg Festival? The finest singing crew in all of Austria, the greatest choir in all of Europe, and the best soprano in the world.
Max, that's something I'd love to hear.
So would I. But all I've gotten up to now is a basso, isn't even profundo.
Oh, Max, you always come up with a good festival concert.
Thank you. You know why? It's because my motto is, never start out looking for the ones you wind up getting. That's why I've been telephoning all over the place. Paris, Rome, Stockholm, London.
On Gail's telephone?
Why else would I be up here?
I hoped it was because you like me.
Of course I like you. Why wouldn't I like you? You live like a king. You have an excellent wine cellar. I'm sorry, I like the way rich people live. I like the way I live when I'm with them. Say, Gail, speaking as a government official, is there a cathedral around here?
That's Nürnberg Abbey.
Do they have a choir?
A beautiful one.
Good. In the next few days, I have to visit all the towns around here, listen to the choirs, quartets, zingermans.
You'll be here for news, won't you?
Of course, yes. It was in a town just as this where I first discovered the St. Ignatius Boys Choir. They won the festival, toured all over the world and became very famous.
Oh, yes. What ever became of them?
By the time their voices changed, they were rich enough to live in America. Say, Gail, who lives in that dilapidated castle down there? Rumpelstiltskin.
That's Baron Elmerfeld, the oldest family in the village.
I'd like to meet them. I'd like to meet all your friends. Gail, why don't you give me a dinner while I'm here? Nothing very much. Just something lavish.
I wouldn't know whom to invite. These days it's hard to tell who's a friend and who's an enemy.
Well, this isn't a very good time to make enemies. Let's make some friends.
I can't understand what's happened to the children.
Well, you're not worried about them, are you?
They should have been here to welcome you.
Well, it couldn't have been an intentional sight, because they haven't even met me yet.
Forgive me. I'll try to find them.
Elsa, have you made up Georg's mind yet? Is he going to marry you or not?
Oh, yes. Well, he hasn't admitted it yet. There seems to be something standing in his way.
And you don't know what it is?
No.
I do.
What?
Well, you see, it's actually quite simple, really. It's money.
Money.
Yes. He's rich. You're rich.
Oh, Max.
In all the famous love affairs, the lovers have to struggle. He got rooms away upstairs, the lovers star and snuggle. Their famous for misfortune, which they seem to have no fear of. Our lovers who are very rich, you very
have a
What do you want?
Oh, Captain, I don't see you. I mean, I didn't see you. Oh.
Who are you?
I have a telegram for that dead father.
I am that dead father.
Thank you.
You've delivered the telegram. Now get out.
Georg, he's just a boy.
And I'm an Austrian. I will not be hired.
Georg,
what's going to happen is going to happen. Just make sure it doesn't happen to you.
Max, it's a good thing you haven't seen character. Otherwise, I'm convinced I would hate you.
Couldn't hate me. I'm much too lovable.
No, dead father.
There's a call for you. It's
oh, thank you. Franz, I'll take it.
Straight line. Get cleaned up, get into uniform, and report back here. At once! Fräulein, where did you get these abominations? Out of a nightmare!
No, Captain, out of some curtains. Well, the curtains is used to hang in my bedroom. Oh, there was plenty of wood left in them.
You mean to say the people of this neighborhood saw my children in all the curtains?
Mm-hmm. They've become very popular, sir.
Oh, I don't wonder.
They say, there goes Captain Von Trapp's children.
My children have always been a credit to my name.
Oh, but Captain, they weren't. They were just unhappy little marching machines.
Don't tell me about my children.
Well, you must hear from someone home long enough to know
this. I said I don't want
I
to
know
hear.
You don't, but you've got to. Now take Liesl, Captain. Liesl isn't a child anymore, and if you keep treating her as one, I'm afraid you're going to have a mutiny on your hands. Afraid to go, Captain. He's afraid to be himself. He's shy. He's aloof.
Don't tell me about my
Brooke
son.
Brooke could tell you all about him. She could tell you lots more if you get to know her because she notices things. And she always tells the truth, Captain. Especially when you're not to hear it. And Kurt, Captain, he's sensitive. He's easily hurt. And you ignore him. You brush him aside like you do with all of the... Oh, I haven't finished yet. And Louisa just wants to have a good time, Captain. Later have a good time. And Marta will... I don't know about Jake, but someone's going to find out about her. And then little Greta, Captain, who just wants to be loved. Love
the children. Stop that. You will pack your things and return to the Abbey as soon as you can.
Oh, I'm sorry, Captain. I shouldn't have said those things. Why not in the way I said them?
I'll take one of the news with you. What's that? Who's singing?
Your children.
My children. Singing.
I want them to sing for Frau Schreid, and when they're mad, Captain.
Georg, you must hear! Children are.
Children? I would like for you to show Frau Schrader the gardens.
Yes, show me the gardens. I want to see everything. And with you too. I don't know any of your names yet, but I'm sure I won't get them right for a long time.
I'm Martha.
No, you're not. I'm Martha.
He's not.
I don't know my own children.
Oh, Captain, they waited to know you. You want so much to do. Well, after I've gone,
no, I want you to stay.
What if I can be of any help then?
You've helped already. You've brought music back into my life. It's been so long since this house has been filled with music.
Oh, Captain, the children, they love music, Captain.
I know. In this past while, I've forgotten. To laugh like a brook when it trips and falls over stones in its way. To sing through the night.
Come along. I remember the beautiful ladies. And everybody laughing.
There was one lady, the most beautiful of all. I think she was here all the time. Yes,
honey. Can we dance while the guests are dancing?
Of course.
Just remember what Fräulein Rindel.
German, I'm Austrian.
Well, there's going to be Auslisch. I warn you and everyone like it. And that goes for the great
shit.
And that goes for the great
shit.
Appelfeld, nice to have you and the Baroness here again.
Thank you, Captain.
Frau
Schreiner
again.
So she's not ill?
Oh no, just a headache. We're about to head up to the terrace. We'll meet you there.
People are having a very good time.
Well, half the people are inviting them speaking to the other half.
Well, Father, maybe they're having a good time not speaking to each other.
Oh, sir, my father asked me to let you know that she'll be joining you in a few minutes.
I see whether she'd like it or not.
You know what? I've danced.
Left hand down back.
That's right. First of all, you go.
President in the world.
Thank you, Max.
Max, you're back. And as usual, just in time for dinner.
Yes, did you think you were going to throw a gala without me?
Oh dear, but now we've an odd man.
Maybe a little odd, yes, but charming indeed.
So, but now for us, we need to set two more places for dinner. And I want to see from Andrea.
Two places?
Yes, we'll need another woman.
Oh, Liesl?
Oh, no, she's much too young. I was to ask for Andrea.
You're not serious, are you?
But of course.
She's a nursemaid.
I don't think of it that way.
I understand. It's just, you can't expect your guests to dine with her.
And why not?
Elsa, tell him why not.
Oh, Max, can you change in a hurry?
Yes, Max, we can use it tonight.
Gail, you must understand. Frau Schreider, they're talking about you out there. Oh, come on, Gail. I've been dodging these people for an hour.
Have you seen your father?
Frau Maria!
Oh, Abbott, well, it's so nice to see you again.
Touché.
I knew it all along. Frau Schreider didn't have a headache. She just wanted to get out of the party. She was faking. It's very important that your children don't say things you don't know are true, you know? But I do know. I heard her say to father she'd been dodging these people. And that doesn't mean she didn't have a headache. It's very important that your children like Frau Schreider. I like all right. Why is it important? Well, I think she's going to be a new mother. Oh, Fraulein, father's never going to marry her. Why, he couldn't. Why couldn't he? Because he's in love with you.
No, Brigitte, this is a, you must know, Jack, remember the other night when we were all sitting on the floor singing the Edelweiss song he taught us?
Brigitte,
you laughed at him for forgetting the words. Well, he didn't forget the words. He just stopped singing to look at you. And when he speaks,
no, Brigitte, no.
The way his voice sounds. And the way you looked at him just now when you were dancing.
Brigitte,
you're in love with him.
Okay, one more dance better, then I'll spare. Ah, Frau Andrea. We're going to have dinner with the children tonight. They're having dinner time with us.
No,
oh, yes, it's all arranged. You'll have to hurry. We'll have to change. And Maria, wear the dress you wore the other night. It was lovely, soft and white.
Ah, shall I announce dinner, Captain?
Oh, no, not yet. The children will want to say good night. Oh, Gail, did the children say goodnight they did the other night? It was so sweet.
No, Elsa, not here.
Oh, please, Gail.
Not in front of the strangers.
Please, Gail, for me.
Elsa.
Presto, Jacob.
That's just in time. Children, now.
Say goodbye, goodbye.
exactly like this. Find it here.
Wait a minute, Max.
Seven singing children, all in one family.
Max, Gail never even wanted him to sing in front of his guests. I had to persuade him.
Well, there it is then. You must talk to them.
Max!
Elsa, it is for Austria. And it wouldn't do me any harm.
Bless you, my daughter. Sister Sophia, please take her new ostrich to their own room. Ave.
Maria is here to see you. I know it's taken a long time.
I've waited until she wanted to come to me.
It's strange. She's happy to be back, yet she's unhappy too.
Why don't they send her back? Do you know?
She doesn't speak. She hasn't said a word except in prayer.
I shall see her.
Maria.
This must have been a trying experience for you, my child.
Oh, it was, little mother.
Has it taught you anything?
Well, I've learned that I don't want to leave these walls yet.
Maria, why did they send you back to us?
They didn't send me back, little mother. I left. I left without telling them I was going, without saying goodbye.
Sit down, Maria. Maria, what happened? Why did you do this?
Oh, I was frightened, Grandmother.
Frightened?
I was confused. I've never felt this way before. I knew I couldn't stay, and I knew that here I would be safe.
Oh, Maria, our Abby is not to be used as an escape. What is it you can't face?
I can't face him again.
Thank you, Sister Margareta. Maria, are you in love with Captain Funtra?
I don't know. I don't know, Little Mother.
Tell me about it, my child.
Paquita said that I was, that her father was in love with me. We were dancing, looking at each other, Mother. I could hardly breathe. Then I knew I couldn't stay.
But you do like him, Maria.
Oh, yes.
Did you let him see how you felt?
If I did, I knew that I did. This has been torturing me. I was there in Carter, but you asked for the captain's love, but I've been wrong.
Maria, the love between a man and a woman is holy too. The first time we talked together, you told me you remembered your father and your mother before they died. Do you remember? Were they happy?
Oh, yes, Mother, they were very happy.
You, my child, were born of their happiness and of their love. And you, Maria, has a great capacity to love. But what you must find is, how does God want you to spend your life?
Well, I've faced my life to God's service. I've faced my life to God.
Maria, if you love this man, it doesn't mean that you love God less. You must find out. You must go back.
Oh, please, Mother, don't send me back. Please, if you stay here.
Maria, these walls weren't built to keep our problems. You are to face them. You have to find the life you were born to live.
How do I do that?
You'll look for it.
Mm-hmm.
Now sing seriously. He's gonna give us a key. 3, 2, 1.
Shall we surround?
That's nice. Just no good at all. Picture this. You're standing in a big concert hall.
What concert hall, Uncle Max?
Any concert hall. Carlsberg concert hall. You're standing in Carlsberg concert hall, and it's filled with people. Now, let's try again. 3, 2, 1.
Turn me some down.
Greta, why don't you sing loud?
I've got a sore finger.
Now, you know you can sing loud, Uncle Max. The night of the party, you sang so beautifully, so full of spirit. Come, let's try once more. In your formation. 3, 2, 1.
Down, me, down, down.
They try to sing for me, the poor darlings, but it's just not as good as they used to be.
We need Fräulein Maria.
We do not need Fräulein Maria. You can sing just as well with me.
Georg, I have experience with choirs, quartets.
Marie Clark, please. Now, what would you like to sing?
Do a deer, a female deer, ray a drop of golden sun, me a name.
Father, Fräulein Maria always.
You're not to mention Fräulein Maria.
Oh, come on, Max. I feel like a biscuit.
Yes, that's just what I need. Georg, is anyone using the car?
Now, what are we going to sing? Did you play any of your tricks and of your jokes on Fräulein Maria?
Only those she liked and laughed at.
You didn't put toads in her bed?
No, Father.
Well, something must have happened for her to leave us without even saying goodbye.
Is Fräulein Maria coming back?
I don't think so, darling.
But she was the best governess we ever had.
Well, you're not going to need a governess anymore.
Oh, good.
I'm not sure that's so good.
You're going to have a new mother.
A new mother?
Frau Schreiger?
Oh, yes. It was all arranged last night. And I'm very happy. Well, it's time for your afternoon walks.
A new mother!
When Fräulein Maria wanted to do it, she used to sing that song. Remember? All right. Let's try it.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens. Bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens. Brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things.
Why do
you
not feel this?
Those who are dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and my lashes, silver white fringes and nibs into springs.
Darling, we have to face them. Oh, children, I have so much to talk to you about.
We have some things to tell you, too.
You must have a great deal to tell me.
Well, I guess the most important thing is that Father's going to get married.
Married?
to Frau Schreiner.
Jules, are you sure?
Oh, yes. He just told us. He told us himself.
Come on, Father. We found him.
Liesel.
Louisa, Brigitte, Boyd, Maria, Fukino,
Bridget.
You came back.
Yes, Captain.
You left us without an explanation whatsoever. Without even saying goodbye.
That it was very wrong of me. Forgive me.
Why did you leave us? Tell me.
Oh, please don't ask me. Anyway, the reason no longer exists.
Then you're back to stay.
Well, only until you can make arrangements.
Oh, no. Children have missed you so terribly. I've missed. Everybody's missed you so very much. Nothing was the same while you were away. Everything was wrong.
Captain,
we'll talk about it later. You go up to the children now. And to Maria. A new dress.
Oh, Captain, we have a new postulant. I know I'm right, Max. We'll find her not.
I'll take your word for it.
Yeah, you all. Settle this for Max and me, will you? How far down the mountain does your property go?
You see that stone wall over there? That's the property line.
See? I told you.
I didn't argue about it.
I know. That makes me furious. I hate to win without a fight. Sir Georg, tell me a bit more about your property.
Well, we moved here about 10 years ago. But since then...
So, Max, how's the plan for the festival going?
Quite fine, actually. Just, perfect.
Detweiler, while you were gone, you had a long discussion with one
of them. Who could be calling from Berlin? Know who it was. Hey, what were we just talking about?
Max, this isn't the first call you've had from Berlin.
Georg, you know I have no political convictions. Can I help it if other people have?
Let's not stir that up again. The Germans have promised not to invade Austria. That's known as that.
Then why does he bother to answer those calls from Berlin?
Well, because if they don't keep their promise, I'd like to have some friends among them.
Naturally.
Well, you agree too.
Okay, look at it this way. There was a man, he was dying, and they were giving him his last rites. They asked him, do you renounce the devil and all his works? You know what he said to them? At this moment, I prefer not to make any enemies.
Okay, if they should invade us, would you defy them?
Yes.
Are you mad? Do you know what might happen to you? To your property?
To your children?
To everyone close to you? To Elsa.
To me. Well, what would you do if they invade us?
What any man with any sense would do. Sit tight and wait for it all to blow over.
And you think it will?
One thing's for sure, Gail. Nothing you can do will make any difference.
Well, don't get so serious, darling. Take the world off your shoulders. Relax. You dear, attractive, dewy-eyed idealist. Today we'll have learned to be a realist.
You may be bent on wooing bees of herring blue, but up against a shark, what can a herring do?
Be wise, compromise.
Compromise and be wise.
Let them think you're on this side, non-committal.
I will not bow my head to the men I despise.
You won't have to bow your head to stupid little.
Why not learn to put your faith and your reliance on an obvious and simple fact of science? A crazy planet full of crazy people. Sun is floating all around the sky, and every time it turns and I'm a summer song, a lovely day goes by. And there's no way to stop it, no, there's no way to stop it, no, you can't stop it even if you try. So I'm not going to worry, no, I'm not going to worry, every time I see another day go by.
cockeye tangle. We make a cockeye circle round the sun. And when we circle back to where we started from, another year has run. And there's no way to stop us, no, there's no way to stop it. If the earth wants to run around the sun, you're a fool if you worry, you're a fool if you worry. Special feature, me. So every star and every whirling planet and every constellation in the sky revolve around the center of the universe, a lovely thing called I. And there's no way to stop it, so there's no way to stop it. Now I know, though I cannot tell you why. In the lion's mouth.
Thank you, France. I'll take it later.
You might as well take it down, Max.
Go. Just go.
Gale, I feel I know what's going to happen here. Can't you see things my way?
Not if you're willing to see things their way.
You know, there's one thing he'd be too busy to hear than me to Indiana. Your senses. I'm going to miss
Captain!
Oh, I beg your pardon.
Maria! Gable, you didn't tell me Fräulein Maria was back. I'm delighted.
Oh, thank you. Well, Captain, the children like to know if they could take a holiday from their lessons tomorrow so that we could go on a picnic.
Yes, I don't mind.
Oh, that would make them very happy. And may I get permit to do wish you happiness too, Frau Schneider? Captain, the children have told you to be married.
Oh, I'm afraid the children are wrong. Gale, I've got to finish my packing if I'm going to get back to you.
If you feel you must, I'll tell France to have the car ready.
I can do that. A bit is in there. Goodbye,
Maria. Well, Captain, I'm sorry if I said something I shouldn't have said.
You did say the wrong thing, but at the right moment.
And the children told me you made it for our Schneider.
We found it just couldn't go the same way. That door was shut.
Sister Margaret always says, when God shuts the door,
I know. He opens another window. Maria, why did you run back to the Abbey? What made you come back?
Holy Mother Agnes, she told me that you have to go and look for your life.
Often when you find it, you don't recognize it. Well, not at first. But then suddenly one day, one night, stands in front of you.
Why, yes.
As I look at you now, I realize this isn't something that just happened. I've known it for quite a while. And I think you did too. What is it that told you?
Oh, Brigitte. Oh, she said we would dance.
She was quite right. That wasn't just an ordinary dance, was it?
Well, I had a dance since I was a very little girl. It's what you love you grown up, isn't it?
Maria, when you were a very little girl, the very little boy would kiss you.
Uh-huh.
That's why.
Oh, it is? Oh, it is different.
Your whole life would be different, Andrea. I'll take you where you wish to go.
I don't want to go anywhere. All I could wish for is right here. Some
Someone I should go to ask permission to marry you.
Why don't we ask the children?
Thank you.
look at myself, I go to wear it in my suitcase.
Sister Barbara.
Sister Margareta?
Oh, I think Maria's forgotten to put in the linings.
Sister Barbara, the maroon. Let me say it for you. You are indeed beautiful. Thank you.
Children, where are you? Oh, there you are. Come, come, I have something to show you. Is everyone here? Look. Carlsberg Festival, 1938. Look here, the Von Trapp family singers. And here are all of your names. Lisa, Friedrich, Luisa,
Kurt,
Brigitta, Marta, and Gretel.
Why am I always last?
Because you're the youngest.
Now, Luisa, tomorrow the bus leaves at 11 o'clock. I need you all to be ready at that time.
Herr Detweiler, can you help me, please? The Gauleiter is here. He wants to know where the orange flying the new flag is.
Halt!
I tried to explain.
Keep quiet! When is Captain Trapp returning?
No, sir. When a man is on his honeymoon, it's difficult.
It's not nice to answer joking. It's been 4 days since the Auslösch. This is the only house in the province that's not flying the flag of the Third Reich.
You mean the flag with the black spider on it?
Peter,
do you permit such remarks in this house? Who are you?
My name is Maximilian Deitweiler. I am the Minister of Education and Culture.
That was in the old regime.
No, in the old regime I was third secretary. Now I'm first.
Good. And you're all there to fly the flag.
The captain wouldn't. I mean, I can take my orders only from Captain Von Trapp.
You take your orders from us, and so will the captain. Hi!
Why was he so cross?
Everybody's cross these days.
Is Father going to be in trouble?
You know, he doesn't have to.
Uncle Max, are you sure that he's going to be all right with Father?
Yes, Brigitte, I'll be pleased and proud.
Liesel, do you think so?
Brigitte, do you not trust me?
No.
Anyway, the bus leaves at 11 o'clock. I need you all to be ready.
Ah, Fräulein Liesel, do you see what I have here?
That's Father's luggage.
Yes, the back.
The back!
Oh, children. They have such a lot to tell us. Let's not hurry on telling them anything.
Sure, Max. Oh, Max.
Georg, we weren't expecting you back until next week.
Max, could you hear? There's so much we want to know.
Children, we miss you so very much.
Where is Mr. Barrows?
What's all that noise you make in the morning?
That noise you make telling each other to be quiet.
And of course, we miss you when you sing.
Look, Father, we're going to sing at the Carlsberg Festival Friday night.
We see that. Max, are you responsible for this?
Georg, I've just been waiting for the right time to tell you.
You can't talk your way out of this one.
Georg, listen to me. I was very fortunate to be able to enter them into the festival at all. But they'll be the talk of the town. Seven singing children, all in one family.
Not for my family.
Georg, the committee heard me. They were enchanted.
Oh, really? What did they say?
Never heard such praise.
Oh, Gail, did you hear?
The Von Trapp family does not sing it for.
But if the main people have any...
And for the festival, people come from all over the town.
It's out of the question.
Georg, it's for Austria.
There is no Austria.
The Auslösch happened peacefully. Let's at least be grateful for that.
Grateful to these swine.
Maria? I admire the way he thinks. But he must at least pretend to work for these people.
No, Max.
Maria, you must talk to him.
Max, I can't ask him to be less than what he is.
Then I will talk to him. If these children don't sing at a festival, well, it would be a reflection on Austria. And it wouldn't do me any good.
No,
oh, yeah.
I want you to ask. Well, I know you love us children, but now I know that you love Father.
Oh, I love him very much, Susan.
Well, how can you be sure?
I don't think first of myself anymore. I think first of him. But I don't know how to spend my love.
A bell is no bell till you ring it. A song is no song till you sing it. Going on 17.
Oh, Ralph, I'm fine.
Amanda, the telegram for Gaxton on track.
Oh, you stay here with Liesl. I'll take it to him.
Amanda, orders to make sure that Gaxton gets it.
Silly Dipper.
I have my orders. Oh, France. This telegram is to be delivered to the hands of Captain Montrap.
Hi!
Hi!
Rolf! Oh, even France?
Yes, even France, even me, even everybody on it, except the great Captain Montrap. If he knows what's good for him, he'll come over to the right side.
Rolf, don't talk like
and
that.
And if he doesn't, he better get out of the country. There are things that happen to a man like that. He better get out quick.
Oh, Liesl, darling, don't cry.
Well, all he wants, but remember what I tell you before it's too late. And you remember too.
How could he turn our father that way?
Maybe it wasn't threatening our father, Liesl. Maybe it was warning him.
Liesl?
Oh, what is it, Georg?
Roland has offered me commission in the Navy.
Well?
I can't just brush it aside. I admit it would be exciting to have a ship under me again. What I mean is it would be a comfort and relief to know that you and the children are safe. But it also means that I don't know what to do, Maria. Help me.
Okay, whatever you decide will be my decision.
Thank you. I know now I can't do it.
Of course not.
You'll have to get out of Austria right away.
You'll have to leave tonight.
Not without my family. And we can't just pick up and leave. They'll be watching us now. We'll have to plan. We'll have to have time.
Sir, Admiral von Schreiber of the Navy, first rank.
Thank you, France. They didn't give us time.
Then we'll have to make time, Georg.
I'll bring them in.
What's going on? Stormtroopers? This is exactly what I was afraid of.
Oh, Max, you stay here with Georg. Please, quickly now, find the children. Quickly, I need them, darling.
Admiral, we can speak in here. Arzela, my presenter, Herr Deadfather. Max, I think you know Arzela. Would you gentlemen care to sit down?
We are here on business.
Captain Lodja, a telegram was sent to you 3 days ago. I've just received it, sir. I've been away. Where did you go off now?
The captain has just returned from his honeymoon, sir.
Congratulations, Captain.
Thank you, sir.
Your record in the war is very well remembered by us.
Good to hear you say that, sir.
Let's get to the point, if you don't mind. In our Navy, we hold you in very high regard. That explains why I'm here. Having had no answer to our telegram, the High Commander sent me in person.
That's very flattering, Admiral, but I've had no time.
I have yet to present you with the commission.
I'm deeply conscious of the honor, sir.
And you are to immediately report to the naval base in Bremerhaven.
Oh, I'm afraid that's impossible for you, Georg.
Admiral, my presents to my wife, the Baroness von Trapp.
Madame?
Oh, what I meant, sir, is the Royal Senior Carlsberg Festival Friday night. You see here the program?
It's been arranged by the Ministry of Education and Culture, sir.
Friday night. This is Wednesday. That's only a matter of 2 days.
It might be possible.
You could report to Bremerhaven by Monday.
Admiral!
Is there a telephone I could use?
Oh, yes, right this way, sir. And, might I suggest adding the weight of my voice?
Captain, it gives here only the name of the children.
It says the Von Trapp family singers, and I'm head of the Von Trapp family.
It's hard to believe, Captain Von Trapp, you singing in the concert.
You may believe what you choose, Arzela.
What are you going to be singing at the concert, Captain?
It's your privilege to come and watch us, sir.
I'd like to see you sing now, Captain. Sing what you're going to sing at the concert.
Oh, please, sir. Will you give us a do, please?
Do. Do, a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun.
Be a name I call myself.
Far along the way to run.
Thank you.
jam and bread, see what jam and bread,
with jam.
Festival has come to its conclusion. Except we don't know what that conclusion is. Our judges are putting their heads together to arrive at their decision, and while we wait, I think there'd be an encore. It has come to me that this may be the very last time the Von Trapp family singers may sing together for a long, long time. I've just been informed that Captain Von Trapp leaves immediately after the concert to report to his new command in the Third Reich. A guard of honor is here to escort him directly after the show to the naval base in Bremerhaven. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Von Trapp family singers, one last time.
Sight. dear, ah dear, to you and you and you. So long, farewell, I'll be losing goodbye.
We flit, we float, we fleety flee, we fly.
So long, farewell, I'll be losing goodbye.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have here the decision of our distinguished judges. We will start with the third award. For this honor, the judges have named the trio of Zanjibun of Herbergen. And now, the second award. For this honor, the judges have named Fräulein Schweiger, the first soloist of the choir of St. Agatha's Church in Moerbach. And now, the first prize. The highest musical award in the Ostmark goes to the Von Trapp Family Singers. The Von Trapp Family Singers.
Outrageous. The church has always been a place of sanctuary.
Not with these people. This is the third time.
Look back! Over there!
It's why we put out in the gardens. They always search the inside, never the outside.
Isn't this God's house?
Shh, yes, Donna.
You must all be very quiet now. I'll let you know now.
After they've gone, can we go home?
No, darling, we still have a long drive there.
Oh, Lisa, let's all sit close to each other now, darling.
Lieutenant!
There's no one here.
All right, come along!
Thank God.
They've gone.
Reverend Mother, I'm so sorry we brought this to you.
Oh, I can never thank you, Grandfather.
After they've gone, we'll head out. We don't climb deep in the woods.
The hall will do you no good. I face the garden, the road in front of the gate.
I've been listening to the wires. The roads are blocked, the borders been closed.
I've always thought of these mountains as my friends, standing there protecting us. Now they seem to have become our enemy.
Oh, never your enemies. Haven't you read? I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills from whence cometh my help.
Oh, Gail, I know that mountain as well as I know this garden. And so do you. You must remember that mountain in Switzerland.
But the children.
Oh, we can help them.
Father, we can do it without
them. Oh, you'll have help. For you will go out with joy and be led forth in peace. And the hills and the mountains will rise up before you to sing.
Thank you.
Dames en heren, uw genoot is het trots. Nog een slag. Kom ons klap vir die hande. En terwijl die hande klap, vraag dat die technische span, die productiespan, Johan, Leandie, dat jullie voor ons hier op die verhoog gedra sal maak, asseblief. So aan kan nie voorbij gaan sonder om een paar dankies te sê nie. En om dankie te sê, klink nou min. Maar Johan, Leandie en die rest van die span, ek dink jullie sal weet dat hierdie jong mense wat hier voor julle staan, die julle gehoor, die julle Wellington, diep in hulle harte, ongelooflik dankbaar, en ja, trots is. Ek het met hierdie produksie bitter min te doen gehad, behalwe om baie grantie buite rond te loop en al die gelukwensinge te ontvang. En ek gee dit allemaal vir julle. Ons het 'n paar dankies, so Johan, sê jy vir ons boon toe kom asseblief? Johan Enston, muzikale directeur. Johan, ik moet nou nie vir die mense sê, maar geleid jy nou daar bolkie met die tiet oor een rust en welgevoel. Die regisseur van die aand, Leandie Strombeck, was Leandie. Julle bosblomme, prachtig, baie dankie. Dan, Ilse, is jy hier? Kostuum. Klein mensie om vir julle baie dankie te sê. Luzay sê sy wil nie op die verhoog kom nie. Sy lyk nie na verhoog nie, maar dis ook om sy op die verhoog moet kom, omdat sy nie so lyk nie, want sy werk hard. Is sy hier agter? Of is sy nog besig om te ruik? Daar is hy! Kom is van son. Op met die stelbe, dan moet ek daarom sê, ons school of daar, meneer Lodee, waar daar vir die mense is geweest. Maar soos het werk met competities kan werknemers ons nou nie deelneem nie. Goed, dan waar is mevrou de Waal?
Lekker mama! Ja!
Waar is ons productiespan? Is hulle al hier onder, André, julle manne? Kom ons gee een lekker ander klap vir ons productiespan. Productiebestuurder André van Blaas. Ek moet sê, dis vreemd om jou aan die kant van die productie te sien, André. Maar dankie, dit was lekker. En dan, die swart geesies wat so jyn en weer vir die verhoog gehaard loop het. Manne, kom, staan na dat. Kom, staan na dat. Kom, staan na dat. Dit is nou van jylle altyd sê, sonder jylle sou dit nie kon doen nie, en dis baie waar. Goed, dan wil ek sommer ook net dankie sê vir die prachtige tafelversierings, vir ons ouers wat elke aand snoepie gehou het, paas en maas, die heerlijke kos vir vanavond, ons orkes, jy het vir ons nog een handeklap vir ons. En dan net van my kant af, dankie vir elkeen wat die aand bygewoon het. Dit is wat maak dat ons vir ons leerling hierdie geleentheid kan gee. Dit was vir my wonderlik. Ek moet sê, dat die hele Wellington stem saam,
En ek staan nou ver van Johanna, want ek dink, ek sal vir môre vra wat doen ons volgende jaar. Baie dankie weer vir iedereen en elk wat hier was. Ons waardeer vooral ons laerskoolhoofde, meneer Skemper, meneer Brubeur, hulle gades en dan natuurlik baie belangrik vir ons ook as skool, ons kringbestuurder Dr. Galat, ons skoolhoof meneer Wieke Snoudee en ons al ons gaste ry veilig huis toe en ons sien julle ander jaar selfde plek, selfde tyd.